Hello, friends. Super, super great news. The local secondhand store that I get most of my jewelry at got a new person to do the jewelry. And in the last three bags, there's been silver. And now there's been some that haven't had anything on it. However, I went today and donated some stuff, and I ran in right before closing, and there was two bags. There's some other bags that didn't have, they were like seashells and stuff, but the two bags I got today, I actually saw gold in one and a couple of pieces of silver in the other. So I'm gonna hurry. So it was $15 a bag. They're still making them pretty empty, but if you've got gold in it, it doesn't matter if it's this empty. So I'm very, very happy about that. Sorry, there's a staple cutting me here. So I was super excited when I saw this. I haven't seen gold like this in a long time. Okay, so the first one I saw was this. Now I don't know why. There was some other ones similar to this in another bag I bought a couple days ago. And I'm gonna leave it. Probably they had it like this so that it wouldn't get tangled because gold necklaces get super, super tangled. And I'll show you the other one in here. But so we're gonna test it with the magnet. So it's not magnetic. All right, so it looks like the clasp has some magnetism in it, which is sometimes normal for gold because real gold is soft and they want to have it be stronger. But I was able to, through the bag, flip the. So in the older 80s-ish gold chains, the clasps were like this. They're no longer like that. And the tags that had the gold content were this triangle, if I can get it. Are like this little triangle size. Can you see that? So the newer ones now are stronger. And they don't look like this, but okay, so they're triangle like that. Can you see that? Okay, so this is more like how they would have had what they would have like notified what it was in like the 80s, 90s, early thousands, I think. All right. So, trying to get it turned to the right direction so I can show you where it says. It's on the other side, I think. Okay, it's just gonna be hard. It's so teeny and it's so wiggly. Okay. So it's super clear, it's super in there. It looks real because of the way it's stamped. And you can clearly see that it's a good stamp. 14K. So, one 14K necklace. Then, well, I don't want to break it. It's a big mess, but let me just. Okay, so there's this mess, and there's this mess, and it's broken. So, I did not do that. So, either when they were pulling it apart to put it in, they pulled it too hard and broke them. So there's one necklace there broken, and I'm guessing, so I'm hoping it's just that one. So there's two necklaces here, and this is why. Actually, it looks like there might be three necklaces. Look, one, two, three. And so this is why I can see why they wrapped them, because this happens with gold. The chains are so small, they get in knots, and then people pull the whole big container up like I showed you. They do this and then it breaks. So my guess is the person who was doing the bagging or the person who donated was trying to pull it apart because it's wrapped around this charm underneath, and by doing so they broke it. So when I'm trying to pull apart gold, I try not to pull. I typically will try and unwind it, but if it's a knot on itself, I show in another video, I just rub the knot between my fingers and the knot will start to move down the chain. And then I rub it and try and get it down to the base of the, okay, it's a little cheerleading, it's a little cheerleader charm, and it was caught on the necklace. So I'm going to put the charm down. We'll look at that in a minute because I want to, okay, so I think I do see three clasps, I think, in here. So I'm guessing that the cheerleading charm was the one that was broken, the necklace that was broken, and these other Star of David necklaces are the ones that are not broken. There's only one broken chain. Not that it matters, because for gold weight, it's more of what the gold weight is than that, but I think you could sell jewelry more for a little bit more than you can just the gold weight if somebody wants the necklace and the charm that you are having for sale. So, goodness. Oh, so close. Anyway, so if you have something similar to this and it's you're getting it down to where you're letting them hang, kind of, and then sometimes what I'll do is I'll unclasp them and then let them fall. So you might lose a charm off there, so don't do this over, say, shag carpet or in the car. I have actually done this in the car before, and I lost a gold charm for like probably it was about 12 years before I found the charm under the seat. I kept checking for it and looking for it, and I couldn't find it until I was about to sell the car and did a deep clean before I sold the car. But anyway, I did find the charm eventually. So do it over a place where if it drops when you open it like that. Okay, so see, I can just kind of wiggle it a little bit, and the chain is now coming apart because I opened the clasp. So it makes it a little bit easier, but don't ever pull, because I have broken chains myself doing it that way. You're just picking it up and you think it's okay and it's going to be stronger, and they're not. I've broken, I can't tell you how many gold necklaces in my lifetime, or my children, actually. It's not me breaking them, it's my children pulling on them that broke them. So I stopped wearing gold because of that reason. Because you can get thicker silver necklaces. So, okay. Well, anyway, there are three. It's so close. Let me undo this one. See if I can just drop it real quick. This is taking way longer than I wanted it to. But how exciting! Okay. Three. Where's that third one? So even the broken one, I'm going to undo, and we'll see if I can get it to drop. Come on. I should just put it down and pick up something else. Maybe I'll just show you the clasps and then I'll deal with it after. That's what I usually do. But because I did see that there was gold. Oh, the broken one got wrapped around. That's why it was stuck. Okay, we're getting there now. It's easier if you can not leave the tassels hanging down, because they wrap around each other and get caught. Yeah. Very close. Very, very close. Come on. Come on. So, anyway, very happy. So as I was checking out, I'll go back to the story about the store. So as I was checking out, I said, oh my gosh, he goes, are you? I was like one of the last ones out of the store, because I told you I was dropping off some donations before a party I was going to. And when I was checking, I was like, are these yours? And I know all the managers and people over there. I visit with them all the time. And I said, yeah. I said, I'm super excited, because I could see some silver and gold in them, and you haven't had that for a long time. He goes, well, has it gotten better recently? I said, yeah, because I hadn't gotten any gold for about a year. Since the last manager left. And he goes, really, that long? And I said, yeah. I said, Jeremy was the name of the manager. I said, when did Jeremy leave? And he said, about a year ago. And I said, well, since he left, there's been hardly any gold or silver, and usually it's only when it's not marked like really clearly. So somebody was like taking it out of the bags, and so I told him, I said, I just basically, I think somebody was taking all the gold and silver because there haven't been any in the bags except weirdly marked ones that nobody would know about. So there's one. Let me put them back together again. He said, well, good. That's good to know. Okay, this is a broken one. That's both ends of the broken one. And it's super kind of expensive to fix these little chains. It's kind of hard, that, especially when they're broken, where not near the clasp, like in the center, because if they're broken in the center, then people can't, it's, you can see the fix. And so they don't typically fix these small chains, so you just kind of have to recycle them. Okay, here we go. So two of the chains are not broken. The cheerleading one is, but by, let's see, but they all look like they have a similar clasp, which is that same triangle 80s type of clasp. So here is one of the Stars of David. And I didn't check the charms to see if they had any markings on them at the store because I was in a hurry and it was closed. But sometimes the charms if have it and sometimes they don't. GGL. I do not. There is a marking, JGL. It looks like it could be plate. So, anyway, let's look at the necklace. I'm going to look at the clasp, too. I forgot to check on that other one if the clasp was... Come on. Okay. Oh, I flipped it over again. Oh my goodness. Why am I having such a hard time? Right there, 14K. Right there. And I didn't check the clasp. Usually the clasp will say it if it is. However, because it's got magnetism and there's a cut, so I think they may have been repaired or shortened. So here's the clasp cut open. Can you see how it's not even on itself? It's got like a lip on it. But the necklace, let's see. I'm going to check the other one on the back. Some of the markings look like they weren't quite stamped. They look like they had something written on them, like covering it. So let's try this one. JGL. Yeah, I'm pretty sure these are plate. All right, but let me show you why. So it says JGL, but if you look in the corner, the top of the L, there's a black hole. Can you see it kind of right there? Small, but anyway, let's look at this chain and make sure. Let's see. This chain does not look like it's been fixed, and it looks like there's markings on it, so... Okay, so I'll show you the markings on both. So there's 14K right there. But then also, Okay, so 24 karat gold is 925. This is saying 585. So this also is 14. You see that? There. So 3 14 karat necklaces so far. And I have this broken one. And I'm going to clasp them together so I don't lose the one half or the other. Now, you could take this and get it shortened, because this is how much is broken off. Or you can get it fixed. But when you get it fixed, like I said, it will kind of have a bobble, a soldering. Oh, sweet, another 14K. 14K. So now I'm going to look at the charm. So that one could be fixed smaller. Okay, so there's a charm. It's got a nice ring to it. It's not acting magnetic. This looks pleated. So it was probably a charm they picked out. I don't think it's 14K. Let me show you why I think it's pleated. It's not really crisply defined like you would see in a pour. And see that big dark chunk right in there? Right in the center. Looks like where some plate has come off. So just kind of has a plate look. So we've got four so far, four gold necklaces, 14K karat gold necklaces, and none of the charms. I'm gonna check the charm on this one. It didn't wasn't magnetic. This also looks like it could be plated. Oh, there's a little diamond chip in there. I'm not seeing that it's marked separately. Oftentimes on something like this, it'll be stamped right here on this area here, or along the bottom here, or sometimes on the edge. And I'm not seeing that. Doesn't really matter. I've already made my $15 back anyway. So, woohoo for me! So whatever else we find is definitely a Yahoo moment. Okay, this is a dumb thing they have in here. A wire, copper wire name or something somebody's put on here and it's just caught everything on it. I kind of want to just pull it straight, but I don't want to break anything. Okay, come on, loosen up. So, how about that weather? I don't even know what to do with this pile of mess. Oh. Shoot. Okay, I may have to do them separately. Okay, this one right here is magnetic. This one right here is magnetic and the clasp is wrong. That's that little weird clasp. But if we don't have pressure on it, you can see. Okay, there is this lovely spongy little girl's dress up. Not real crystals, fake crystals. Let's see. There is a Another one of those type. Okay, not magnetic. Sometimes these ones are silver. So the back of the charm does not look silver. It looks copper plated. So it just doesn't look real. So I'm going to go to the clasp of it. Okay. Look at the clasp and the type of thing. That does not look real. The type of clasp is just cheap looking and it's broken. And there's this little amber Amanda heart on a gold chain, which we're pretty sure is not real. It's gonna take me forever to get that off of there. I can just tell you it's not real. There's no way that's real. Just doesn't have the right look. Although the top of the silver, this is silver, the top here, and then the chain is gold. It looks like a little girl's gold chain though. It does not look real. So if we can go to the clasp, that's the clasp. And it does not look real. Then we have a sea enamel pin that is not real. It's got a brass back on it. And then the last necklace is this. It doesn't feel real, it doesn't sound real, it doesn't look real. Cross. And then there's a little horsey charm on the bottom of this one that we tested towards the beginning. And it is not real. But it is quite a cute little horsey charm. Some little girl like that. So there's that. Sorry. But look at this cute little alarm clock. Circa alarm clock. Little teeny clock. There was a whole collection of these in different bags that they were selling. I don't know if people collect these anymore. It's made in China. Circa Japan Movement 11.561. So I don't know. If you know anything about that, let me know. I will put that aside. Okay. Then we have this necklace. It looks like a choker. It looks like it would fit around my ankle. It looks like it may have been repaired. It looks more like a, I don't know, 80s designer. The gold is wearing off of it. And I have them, that type of a clasp. So I know it's not real gold. We're not even going to worry about it because the plating is wearing off of it. And look how lovely this is. Gotta love this. Look at this, like a 50s choker. It's so pink. Anyway, it doesn't look pink in the color, but these are bright pink. So that's fun. Somebody's going to love that. But look how cute. They're like little gold balls. White with gold on them. That's really cute. I like that. Okay, here's something I looks could be promising. It looks like a turquoise and silver necklace. But it's kind of got a weird doesn't look like it's real on the back, but the chain feels real. So let's look at for markings. Sarah Cove. So it's a designer. No markings for silver. But it still looks good. Actually kind of a pretty, that's the back. I like the chain, the way the chain is. I don't really like the fake turquoise, but I like the chain. That's pretty. Next, such a fun day. I like these beads in between. Look how funky those are. That's fun. Interesting. Look at those. Not real, but still quite interesting. They're very goldy. Just a little different. Wouldn't it be cool if this was real silver? But it does not feel real silver. It feels very lightweight. Kind of fun, though. I don't know. Maybe one of my kids will like that. Ooh, I like this. So cute. Look at this. It's honeybee. Cute. I can't tell if there's a designer mark on it or not. It's plated. Don't think it's a designer mark. I think it's a stud. Just like a stud there to attach it. But isn't that cute? Very cute. Yeah, it's one of the cuter pins I've ever gotten out of the bag. If I could hold it, it would be very cute. That's fun. I like that. That's a different thing. Oh my goodness. Finger fit 14K. Oh my gosh, is that a wedding band? Oh my gosh, I did not see this. 14K Columbia. Oh my I don't think it's a real diamond because it's reflecting light, but it's 14K. Gosh. What? Look how beautiful that is. Oh It's got this fun little keeper on it. Okay, let me show you the marking. One of the best bags ever. This is up there with the cufflink box for 10, $15. Oh my gosh, I can't believe it. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. I hope I can show it to you. It's really hard sometimes to show you the middle of rings. See right there? 14K is right there, and then it says Columbia. And then, it. It's like a flower. It's so pretty. Let's see if you can see that. Don't know if you're going to be able to see it. It says right there, it says finger keeper 14K. Let's see if I can get to the 14K part. It's so hard. Anyway. Look at how pretty that is. I may have to hit pause. At the end of the video, I will go get my diamond tester, but I don't think it's a real diamond because I'm seeing reflections of rainbows, and that's typically not. And another way you can test if you don't have a diamond tester is to blow on it. A real diamond will not hold your moisture on it. It will not get fogged up. So. So you breathe on it and it's not holding any moisture that I can see on it. So, oh my gosh, that is a big one. That's at least a carat. So if that was a real diamond, I will kiss the computer screen. I'll get my diamond tester at the end. I'll hit pause after I go through the rest of the bag. Suspense. And I will then go and get my diamond tester. Now, I don't know if I can look at the rest of this bag. SAC. It is plated. That is a thick chain, though. I look like a rapper. It's a big chain. That is heavy. For recyclable, that is super heavy. Oh my gosh. Please be real. How did I not see these rings in this bag? How did I not see them? Oh my gosh, please be real. It doesn't look like it's real. Looks not real. Oh yeah. Man, I just had a heart attack for a minute there. It is not, it looks plated. Oh, it looks like it's got a lot of gunk and goo in it. Oh yeah, it's been plated. Okay, so you can kind of see there it's gold here and then it's not gold there. I should have looked at the base before I started looking on the inside. But still super pretty. Oh, and then there's copper showing at the top. Darn it. Still a fun ring. I can see what's in there, though. It's definitely had better days. But it's copper, so it's not going to be magnetic. And yeah, you can see clearly. Look at the difference. The gold color. See, this is gold, real gold, and this is not real gold. So, anyway, what if there's another one in there? Wouldn't that be exciting? Oh, this looks silver. What is this? What is this? Recognize it? Can you tell what it is? It looks silver and it says my gosh, I don't know what it says. It's got all sorts of TRA 123 TRA some kind of Greek symbols or something. VW, little R, a no, ton or not. And I have no idea what it is, but it looks like it's silver. And it is 925, and it says Mexico right on there. So I have no idea what it is, but it looks silver, and I was right. There's a marking right there. Nine two five, Mexico. So this bag is turning out to be the best bag ever. Oh, wait. Gold charms, I hope. That one on the bottom looks real. The dolphins, I don't know. Oh my gosh, this was stuck inside of this bracelet. This bag insert was completely inside this bracelet. Okay, so there's dolphins and this little basket. Okay, so there's a little basket, filigree basket. Does not look real from the back. From the front, it looks like it could be real. And then there's dolphins. Once again, the back does not look real, but the front looks like it could be real. So we're gonna do this. Okay, there is magnetism in that one. Little magnetism in this one. Don't see any markings. Okay. Not seeing anything make me think it's real. Sometimes it's at the top, like on that silver one, so I'm just gonna look at the top. It does not look real. Darn it. So happy for a minute. I'm not complaining. I got a whole bag full of stuff, but okay. Anyway, so there's those. I'm sure they're plated, but oops. Okay. Oh, any more excitement? I don't know. There's copper coming through that. So that's silver plated. I don't know that anybody would wear it with it coming through, so I'm gonna go ahead and put that in recycling. Okay, I don't see any designer marks. It feels very heavy though. Could be a designer. It's plated, silver and gold plated. Yeah, and it looks plated. If I hold it up close, you can kind of see that. And that's what I've tried to explain on other things, that when it's bubbly like that and kind of not crisp, it usually is plated. But somebody might like that. It's still pretty. I hate these kind of bracelets. They catch on everything. I will not be keeping that. A 50 years Daughters of the Pioneers pin. So, yeah, it doesn't look real. See the markings on that. It's just brass. It's not magnetic, but it's just brass. Years of pioneers. That might sell on eBay. I don't know. I'd have to look that up. A copper and possibly silver. Don't think it's got plated. Earring. One earring. Oh, nope, here's the other one. So, not marked silver. So they've just got the little copper and brass tacked on top. A toe ring for $4. You two can have this little pink. Sometimes I've actually found a bag of toe rings before that was actually silver. This one feels magnetic. It's picked on. That might be the snout. Staple. There is a label in there. It's made in Thailand and it is. Oh, it is silver. Well, there you go. It says it on the inside of the label inside. I'm not gonna be able to show you that label right there. It on the inside. Oh, wait. Let's see if you can read through it. Oh, almost. Anyway, it's so sterling silver. A little pink toe ring. My, this has been a great bag. That I would spend 40 minutes on this $15 bag. I was gonna have them done in 10 minutes. Okay. This is a homemade jewelry, and it's made very weird. The beads are, I don't think, glass. Maybe they are. It's very weird looking, but look how they did this bead. They took this really pretty little diamondy bead, and look how they threaded it. I always check these because sometimes people will make jewelry with silver clasps on it, even though they made it very weird. And these beads are not really that pretty anyway. They're kind of weird shaped. This one may be silver, but I'm not seeing. And they used wire, so they're kind of scratchy. I'm going to look and see if I can see if it's copper coming through at all. I can't tell, but it's not magnetic. So I can't imagine anybody's going to wear that the way that it is, but I really think those little weird, those are pretty. I don't like the whole necklace, but I like these beads. So I may just use that as a bead. I don't even want the beads. It's not worth it. I don't want it. Not real. One ammo. Oops, now it's stuck on my wooden clip-on. A Geneva Elite watch. But I'm checking because sometimes I've actually had silver beads, but they're not. So there's the watch and the beads. It's actually kind of teeny. Somebody may like that. I know my kids don't wear watches, so I'll put that in the donate because somebody actually might like it. The lady I've been giving the watches to has a ton now, and I don't think she needs any more. I'm not going to untangle that. So not real. It's such a good day. I think it's silver. Look at it. It might actually even be white gold. What is it, though, is the question. It has batting on it, so it's been in a jewelry, like a little box, like a jewelry box, like a gift box. It's weird. I've never seen anything like that. However, it's got a tag. It's got a tag. Look at the tag. It's got a tag right there. See that tag? That usually means it's real. 925. Yes. Except now I'm concerned because that tag is plated and the clasp says 925, but it also looks plated. But the charm doesn't necessarily look plated, but I don't see that it's marked. Is that plate? Looks like it might be copper. I'm just tarnished. I can't tell. Actually, it looks like it could be copper underneath or tarnished. So that's, even if it is copper, it's not going to be magnetic. So, all right. Well, there's no magnetism. So that's a good sign because the ones that are plated in China, from China, are magnetized. So, okay. So the clasp is magnetized. See if I can see if that's magnetized right there. It's interesting because the clasp says 925. There's a little bit of magnetism in the clasp area, but the rest of it looks good. So I'm going to go with it. The clasp area. So, looks like another silver. Oh my gosh, this is like the best bag ever. And I get a bird earring to boot. Look at this purple bird earring. Would have been cuter if it wasn't purple. A little silver. Look how cute that is. I'd wear that. Not purple, but I'd wear that. Pink. But of course, there's only one. Dang it. Wooden earring. Blue stud. Ugly green something or others. Maurice's. This is super, super heavy. Pink. Pearly bracelet. Very good dress-up bracelet for a little kid. Although it's not very springy, so it might end up breaking. So I think I'm not going to keep it for my granddaughter. Okay, so then there's this. It feels like it's aluminum. It's not magnetic. But it feels very cheap. And if it's gold, I would be so happy. This is very hollow, and that's why I was thinking aluminum. But sometimes I have had real gold that feels like that in bracelets because they're hollow. But the clasp is not looking real to me. It looks kind of cheap to me. So, yeah. Feels like it's like a kid's with aluminum. Kind of very light, very, very light. So it's not going to be too bad. And also, if it was real, they often have another chain to keep them from coming apart. So, and a watch of some kind. It's a leather band, and it looks like it has not been worn. Not say anything on that side, and this side says quartz only, and a little diamond ship at the top triangle. So, stainless steel back, water resistant, quartz Japan movement. It's not a bad looking watch. I just can't tell whether it's a man's or a woman's. It's kind of big, but it could be either. It could be a unisex one. I had one of these in the 80s. Look, here's the other earring. And a cancer angel something or other pin. This is the last thing in the bag. And so I had one of these leaves. It was gold dipped leaves. So I'm guessing I've had several of them over the years, but this does look like the one that I have from the late 86-ish. They used to do them at the mall. You'd go to the mall and pick them out, and they were gold dipped leaves, and you could break them open and see that there was actually leaves inside. So, this lovely chain that it's on. There's magnetism to it. But let's check the leaf. A little bit of magnetism, I think. Might be coming through from the chain. But the leaf I had came in a box saying certified dipped in gold. So, it's kind of pretty. I don't know that they'll ever come back, but kind of like it'll probably end up in the recycle for the gold. I don't know that any of my kids would wear it. Okay, so I'm going to hit pause, and then I'm going to get my diamond tester, and I'm going to come back and test that diamond. I don't think it's real, but why would you have a ring that is that gorgeous and not have a real diamond in it. I mean, it's sparkling too much. See how it's kind of... Real diamonds are very dark, deep, and they don't usually reflect quite that rainbowy. When you read about them, they don't usually do that. So, I'm going to hit pause, go get the diamond tester, we'll check it out, okay? I'll be right back. Okay, so I went and got my diamond tester. I have not tested it yet. I did look at the size to see what size it would be. So, apparently the battery, the battery is going dead. No! Dang it! I'll be right back. Okay. Battery. Let's see if it happens. It's a good day. So happy. Okay. They don't normally be that vibrant. Don't normally be. What I was looking at was this. So not quite. I think it's about there's that 1.25 or 1.1 and a half. That's a happy day. Normally they don't sparkle like that, so maybe I'm doing the test wrong. Oh my gosh, I think I'll take it to the diamond store tomorrow, the jewelry store, and test it for me just to make sure. Oh, happy day! Okay, so any which way, I'll let you know on the next video. Well, I'll let you know on another video. I'll show you. I'll post it on my blog. How about that? So... I will not post this video until I take it down and get it tested at the jewelry store, and then I will post it on my blog. So I will put it in the bottom of the thing to find out if it's real. Check out the blog, and I'll make the post on the blog and let you know if it's real. But that is a gorgeous ring. I mean, honestly, why would anybody donate a bag of jewelry with that in it? So pretty. So... my favorite thing out of the bag today is this ring. Even if the diamond is not real, gorgeous, so gorgeous. Sterling silver toe ring from Thailand that is in the bag, new. That was $15 and then was $4. That somebody may just love that as a gift. Okay, then we have this silver little weird charmy thingy that I don't know what it is. It almost looks like a yoke of some kind. And then we have this Mexican, I have no idea what it is, silver from Mexico that says all sorts of weird things that I can't read on it. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I don't know. So, and then we have one 14 karat gold necklace, two 14 karat gold necklace with a broken 14 karat gold necklace, three, four 14 karat gold necklace. And this charm is not. It's just the little cheerleader charm that I'm pretty sure is not real. So, possible real diamond, gorgeous 14 karat gold ring. Very, very gorgeous. I really like this design. Layout is very pretty. Absolutely gorgeous. Love it. Love it, love it, love it, love it. I think I will start wearing that. I am single, but I'm going to wear that. I love that so much. So that was an awesome bag. It took a full hour for a $15 bag, which, you know, that's, they're like a new record, I think. Normally I'm doing two bags in that amount of time. A few trinkets, not a ton, mostly exciting stuff. And I've got these gold-plated charms. Yeah. Oh, happy day. I'll let you know on my blog. Okay, so check out my blog, thesecretofgratitude.com. Check out, type in gold ring grab bag, and it should be under that. And maybe I'll try and link it in the underneath part or something. That seriously is probably, if it's a real diamond, that has got to be, and especially over a carat. It's got to be one of the best grab bags ever for $15. Yay! All right, I'll post this together with the if it's real or not. Okay, so thanks for watching, and I hope you have a very blessed day. One more, I can't hang up.